In this video, we're going to build something in Lovable that has been requested a bunch of times, and that is how to integrate Stripe into your Lovable app so you can actually charge users. So to do this, we're going to build a really simple app. The only purpose is to charge users and then basically mark it as paid in Lovable, and we're going to do this by prompting. So let's start by saying I want to build a simple app that allows users to purchase a product through Stripe, and I want to have our app change a toggle for the user once they have paid. So the Stripe integration is fully complete. The other functionality of the app isn't important right now. I'm only focused on integrating Stripe for a checkout. So I'm going to go ahead and let this run. Let's go ahead and pause the video, and I'll come back once Lovable has finished its first kind of run through here. So here, Lovable came up with this quick, basically premium plan that you can purchase, one-time payment, and then the status to tell us whether the purchase has gone through or not. So it says you'll need to replace the test public key and implement the backend session creation. Would you like to proceed with setting up the backend integration with Stripe? So before we do that, I want to pull up my Stripe account real quick. So Stripe has this new feature called sandboxes. You go to the top left, you click sandboxes. I'm going to create a sandbox, test Lovable. And let's click create sandbox. And I've actually never used sandbox before, but I think it's going to make it a lot easier to test this and just kind of build this out. So we can see we have our API keys that it created, which is really awesome. So we can do this fully in a test environment. Let's go back to Lovable and I'll say, yes, let's proceed. And let's see what happens here. So I'm going to go ahead on the bottom here, click add API keys. It's asking for our Stripe publishable key and our Stripe secret key. And I have these. They're right on the top right of that sandbox that we just created. So I'll go ahead and paste that in and then paste in my secret key and click submit. So it says failed to add API keys. Project is not connected to Supabase. So before we do that, let's connect it to Supabase. So I'm going to go up here. Let's go ahead and go back, create a new project. Now it's going to let me. So I'll say Lovable, Stripe, test. We can put in a password. Doesn't really matter here. It's just a test. And let's click create new project. And then it should bring us back. Well, actually, I don't think it's going to bring us back. We'll have to go back on our own, but that's fine. So now it should be connecting, hopefully, right? Might have to go down and click Lovable Stripe Test. I think it's just taking a second because it just was created. So I'm going to pause the video. Let's give it a minute to generate the project in Supabase, and then we'll connect it. All right, awesome. So now it's working. I'll click Lovable Stripe Test, and we're going to go ahead and just click Connect. So Lovable makes it really easy to connect to Supabase, and I really like that about Lovable. So now it says now it's connected. So now what I'm going to do is let's say please. So let's now add API keys for Stripe. Oh, it says now we've got update Lovable. Okay, so I just have to re-authenticate. You might not have this pop up because it's a very new feature, but I'm going to allow Supabase to do these additional reading and writing directly, which is actually going to help us a lot with our Supabase integration. I'm actually really excited to test this out. All right, so let's go back. All right, so now Supabase has been enabled with all of that, which is cool. So now let's say let's add API keys for Stripe. All right, now it's giving us that button again. So I'm going to copy the publishable key. And again, that's just on your sandbox on the top right. They're going to give you those, or you can go to your developer section of your sandbox Stripe account. I'll go ahead and click submit. So now it says it was successfully submitted. Down here it says I have now added the API keys you asked for. And let's see what it comes up with next. So now it's saying, great, now we have the Stripe API key stored. We need to first create a table to track purchases and their status, then create an edge function to handle Stripe payment processing, and finally update the front end code. So now it's giving me this SQL command. I'm just going to click apply changes. So it's basically creating the purchases table, doing all that. All right, awesome. So now it says it integrated it, and it says I can now test the integration by clicking the purchase now button. It will redirect you to Stripe checkout page where you can use these test card numbers. So Stripe basically gives you these test card numbers. If you just do 424242 over and over again, that will be a success test. So let's go ahead and click purchase now. So I'm going to say when, and this is all about, this is how prompting works with AI apps. You just have to tell it exactly what happened. When I clicked purchase now, I get an error message. Payment failed. Please try again. So let's see what it says to that. So it came up with a few different reasons why that might be happening. It looks like it has to do maybe with the API keys for Stripe that we entered. So it's making some changes here. If I click that, we can see the code that it's editing, and we can even watch it write the code in real time, which I think is pretty cool. All right, now it's saying it should work. So it says make sure I'm logged in, but I don't. There's no login functionality, so I don't know. If I click that, okay, different error. Let's just say try to fix, because it's going to show the error. And if I read it, no user. So that actually might be the issue. And let's see if it figures it out, because it might be thinking we should have a user. It never built that in. And now it should see the error message, no user found. And it figured out exactly what I was saying. And now it's creating a table to store user data, because we never did that. So I reviewed it and it looks good. Please run it. It's basically creating a profile with security and a function to handle new users. All right, cool. So now it's saying sign into purchase first, and then it's going to redirect back to checkout. So let's see. I'll go ahead and enter an email and password. Click sign in. I need to sign up. So it really should probably go to that first, but whatever. I'll click sign up now. It's telling me to check my email to verify my account. App encountered an error. I did get an email to ask me to confirm my sign up. But let's first show it the error. Okay, so it looks like the error was actually just the fact that I didn't have an account yet. So that's fine. For development purposes, we should disable email verification so you can sign in immediately. Okay, so that's cool. I can go in and click that button under email. I can uncheck confirm email and save. So that'll remove it. I did get an email, but let's remove it because it suggested to do that for development purposes. So now we're back. Let's try again. Let's sign up. Seth1@nocode.mba. Password, sign up. Still asking me to check my email, but let's see if it works without it, because I'll just try to sign in. And cool, it did. So we can make that more smooth, but the main thing we're testing here is the Stripe purchase. So now I'm signed in, which is great. Let's click purchase now. Processing. Amazing. It's taking me to the plan. So I can enter my email. It really should pre-fill that with our account, but again, that could be something we would ask it to do. Very easy. All you have to do is enter a date in the future, and then any code is fine here, and pay. So it should take us back to Lovable. It says awaiting status. But you know what? It didn't work because now I'm not in the editor anymore. Interesting. Let me try that one more time. The problem is it took us back to a different URL, which wasn't signed in. Let's try this again. Let's sign up with a new email. Okay, so now I'm on a new email. Let's purchase now. Let's try this one more time. So now I've entered in my information. Let's click pay. And let's see, it should take us back. It says await it. Okay, there we go. Access status, premium access granted. So it actually did work. That is really, really cool. So we set up Stripe. We connected Stripe. We allowed users to purchase. And it sent it back to our app. And it knew that the access was granted. Now, there's more that you could do to integrate. So, for example, if we set up a subscription, then we would want to set up webhooks to check when a subscription is canceled and things like that. But pretty cool that this actually did work. So I actually just asked the AI how it works. So I was curious how it set this up. So for anyone who is wondering, when the user initiates a purchase, well, what we're doing is getting the user's user ID from the authorization header. We're creating a Stripe checkout session. And it looks like we are creating a record in the purchases table with the session ID, the user ID, the amount, and a pending. Then after it's successful, we're checking for a session ID in the parameter URL. So it sends you back with a success URL basically in Stripe, and then it's matching it to the purchases table. If it matches and then we have the user ID, then we know that it was a purchase. So pretty cool. I was wondering how it did it. So basically every time you click, you kind of click purchase, it creates a record in the database. So that's pretty cool. So if you followed along on this video, you have integrated Stripe with Lovable, and you could build an app with Lovable that actually charges users, and you could make money with a Lovable app. So this is something that I'm really excited about. I think it's giving me ideas of things that I could build with Lovable and start integrating Stripe into it to kind of build in that functionality. If you liked this video, be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more free content like this. Click the link in our description to go to Lovable and build this on your own. It's definitely worth checking out. Click on the no-code MBA link in the description if you want to learn more about building with AI and no-code tools and learn from industry experts with in-depth tutorials from start to finish. Leave a comment if you have any questions. Let us know what you want to see next, and we'll see you in the next video.